Sonst leuben dem Tag, was ist wie ein Stein dick Wasser, ein Spiegel on Abschein. Hat schon, was glitschen durch ihm sich herüber, wie boglose Glitches, gehielte in Atems, vermeiden das lichtige Aug von Sikorn. Verwischen dich Spuren, noch heide sie fallen, sonst leuben dem Tag, was du wirst ihm keinmal nicht gedenken. Sonst leuben dem Tag, was du fragst sich sein Namen, und weiß nicht genau, sie ist Heind, sie ist Nächten, und alle Gespäunes mit sich und mit jenem schlafen vermeckte in gräu-weiße Schwammen. Und werte Gesockte und werte Gehärte seinen wie Fischlach, was fallen dadurch durch zerdrivete Netzen, rein in der Stummkeit. Sonst leuben dem Tag, wenn es tut dich nicht quälen, nicht Guff, nicht ne Schamme, wenn rierst deine Glieder und wächst seine Last nicht und hörst nicht dem Däufig von Zeit in dein Busen und schwimmen vorbei vor dein Meuch mach Schoves, was seinen wie Fäden, was hoben kein Knoten, nicht ganz, nicht zerrissen. Sonst leuben dem Tag, wenn es kommen kein Brief nicht, wenn hörst nicht kein Psures, nicht Gute, nicht Schlechte, wenn's klingt nicht der Glock bei dein Tier und der Telefon schweigt und der hilfigste Echo, was greift zu dein Wesen, ist der von der Kusch, was es gibt dir dein Kind mit frische, mit teufeichter Lippen. Wenn's tickt sich das Licht und es fällt zu der Sof und in ein Mittermal, der setzt du sich Stein in a tief dunkel Teuer. Guck noch einmal zurück zu dem Bläserle vor und läub ihm dem Tag, was rinnt euch von dem Sein unbemerkt und verschwindt in der Nacht von Vergessen. So now I guess I'll read the translation, which yes, she did by herself. This is her
translation. You didn't participate in this one?
I changed a word here and there, but that's...
Just checking, okay.
Praise likewise that day, standing still like a water, a mirror without a reflection, though hours that glide through its hazy pale surface like breath-carried skaters are shunning the lighted eye of awareness, erasing their footprints before they are falling. Praise likewise that day you will never remember. Praise likewise that day whose name is the riddle, and you are not sure, is it now, is it later? And all the accounts with yourself and with others are resting hidden in white and gray sponges. And words that you utter and words that you ponder resemble the minnows that fall through ripped net holes deep into the silence. Praise likewise that day when you feel no discomfort of soul or of body. When moving your limbs, you don't feel their burden and you don't hear the pulse of time in your bosom. And throughout your mind, reflections are swimming like gossamer threads without knots or connections, not bound and not torn. Praise likewise that day when no letters are coming, no tidings arriving, not good ones, not bad ones. When silent the bell at your door and the telephone's quiet, and the loudest of echoes that reaches your being is that of a kiss that your baby gives you with lips sweet as honey. When the light is down and the end is approaching, and sudden at last you find yourself standing in a gate of deep darkness, look once more behind you to that bubble of being and praise it that day that drips out of existence, dissolving unnoticed in the night of oblivion.
Thank you. Okay, so I will also post that text onto Facebook afterwards so that people who want to study it again can really go into depth, because it's a lot to take in through one reading, and it was a beautiful reading. What fascinates me about this poem is that it's almost in favor of forgetting. It sounds like she's praising the day when there aren't memories rushing through her head and when thoughts can disappear. And that strikes me as very different from the message in many of her other works, where she's trying to create a space for memory in her literature. What do you think about that tension?
I think basically you're right, but I'm not sure the issue is forgetting so much as having, I think you have to read this with in knowing the background that it's coming from, which is the Holocaust. Mm-hmm. So there you have days where too much happened and none of it good. So here, I mean, what she's saying is, okay, you have a day where maybe you're bored, nothing's happening. But that day is worth cherishing too. Even though there's nothing that'll make you remember this day in particular as opposed to another day.